The third round of the 1951 Formula One World Championship unfolded on June 17th at the renowned Spa-Francorchamps circuit in Belgium. Similar to the previous year, the Belgian Grand Prix didn't attract significant enthusiasm from teams and drivers. The entry list for the event was notably smaller, with many British teams diverted to the Castleton Trophy Libre support race for the Isle of Man TT. Additionally, the absence of Maserati privateers further reduced the field's diversity. Enrico Platé's team intended to field José Froilán González's lone car, but unfortunately, they failed to show up for the event, resulting in the absence of Maserati drivers from the race. Prince Bira had also planned to compete with the Maserati Oscar hybrid, but his team withdrew the car, further impacting the race dynamics. A modest field of only 13 cars lined up for the start of the Belgian Grand Prix, with half of them comprising private Talbot Lago drivers, while the other half consisted of Alfa Romeo and Ferrari contenders. Each Italian team fielded three drivers from their main lineup. The notable development for Ferrari was the return of their team leader, Ascari, who had recuperated from the burns sustained in the Formula 2 race and was ready to compete at full capacity. Between the Swiss and Belgian Grand Prix, the second race of the 1951 Formula One World Championship, the iconic Indy 500 captured the world's attention. Lee Wallard emerged victorious in a thrilling race, showcasing his skill and determination on the legendary Indianapolis Motor Speedway, earning 9 Formula One World Championship points. The event drew massive crowds and generated excitement worldwide, highlighting the diversity and excitement of motorsport across different continents. Qualifying for the Belgian Grand Prix echoed the Swiss round. Juan Manuel Fangio, the championship leader, once again demonstrated his prowess, clocking the fastest lap in 4 minutes and 25 seconds. Notably, Fangio improved upon the previous year's pole position time by a staggering 12 seconds. The reigning world champion, Farina, secured the second spot, trailing the Argentine by a mere 3 seconds. Villoresi, the fastest among the Ferraris, followed closely, lagging only 1 second behind Farina and maintaining a similar lead over his teammate Ascari, who displayed improved form compared to the Swiss round. Piero Taruffi, on the third Ferrari, claimed the fifth spot, albeit 7 seconds behind the pole position. Sanesi, in the third Alfa Romeo, secured the sixth position, trailing Fangio by 11 seconds. Talbot Lago's Rosier emerged as the best among their drivers, conceding a 20-second gap to Fangio. The remaining places in the top 10 were occupied by Giraud Cabantou, Chiron, and Etincelan. Unlike the wet conditions at Bremgarten, the drivers at Spa-Francorchamps were greeted with fair weather for the Grand Prix. This marked a stark contrast to the challenging conditions they faced in the previous race. The upcoming race at Spa-Francorchamps is set to be a demanding one, with drivers required to complete 36 laps. The total race length spans 508 kilometers, promising a challenging and competitive event on the iconic circuit. At the start of the race, the Alfa Romeo duo of Fangio and Farina faced a setback as they struggled to get off the line smoothly. This allowed the Ferrari of Villoresi to seize the lead of the race right from the start. Fangio's initial acceleration was disappointing, causing him to slip back to fifth place behind Villoresi, Farina, Ascari, and Sanesi. The unexpected turn of events added an element of unpredictability to the race, setting the stage for a thrilling battle among the top contenders. Etincelan encountered misfortune right from the start, as his Talbot Lago suffered from transmission problems, leaving him stranded on the start line, unable to join the race. Villoresi managed to maintain his lead, although it was evident that Farina's Alfa Romeo held a quicker pace. On the second lap, Farina successfully passed Villoresi, but the Ferrari driver swiftly reclaimed the lead in the next corner. Fangio started his recovery by overtaking Senesi early in the race, aiming to close the gap to the two Ferraris of Villoresi and Ascari ahead of him. On the third lap, Farina finally managed to overtake Villoresi and claim the lead of the race. Villoresi began to lose ground after that. On the fourth lap, his teammate Ascari seized second place, and a lap later, Fangio also overtook Villoresi's Ferrari. The Ferraris began to lose their grip on the race. Just a lap after overtaking Villoresi, Fangio also passed Ascari to claim second position. Taruffi hadn't been able to keep up with his Ferrari teammate's pace in sixth place, and on lap eight, he retired from the race due to transmission failure. Villoresi was forced to make an unscheduled pit stop to address a leak in the oil pipeline. As a result, he relinquished his position to Ascari and Senesi while his car was attended to in the pits. The race order after 10 laps is Farina, Fangio, Ascari, Senesi, Villoresi, Rosier, and Giraud Cabantou. Alfa Romeo faced a series of setbacks in the pits during the Belgian Grand Prix. Senesi's car suffered from overheating issues with the radiator, forcing him into an early retirement as he came in for his first stop. Meanwhile, Farina, who had been leading comfortably, encountered a lengthy delay during his pit stop, lasting nearly a minute as the team refueled and changed tyres. However, the most significant setback came when Fangio, running in second place, entered the pits on lap 16. A redesign on his suspension led to his left rear wheel becoming stuck on its hub. Despite the team's efforts, it took over three laps to disassemble the car and replace the wheel. Fangio, displaying remarkable composure, re-entered the race from the pits, but found himself at the back of the pack. Despite facing his own challenges in the pit lane, Farina continued to assert dominance in the race. During his second pit stop, he managed to maintain his lead over Ascari's Ferrari, retaining his position at the front of the pack. The race witnessed one final retirement as Sheeran encountered engine problems, leading to his breakdown and subsequent exit from the event. The Alfa Romeo continued to dominate, securing its position at the top as the reigning world champion, Giuseppe Farina, claimed victory, finishing nearly 3 minutes ahead of Ascari in second place. Farina's triumph in the absence of his main rival propelled him to the top of the championship standings. Although Ascari and Villoresi struggled to match Alfa Romeo's pace, they secured the remaining spots on the podium, bringing Ferrari a solid result. Villoresi, finishing third, was particularly delighted as he earned his first points in Formula One. Amid challenges faced by Alfa Romeo and Ferrari, the last points positions were contested among Talbolago drivers, with Rosier and Giraud Cabantou claiming the best spots. After the race, Farina leads the 1951 Drivers' Championship with 12 points, followed by Fangio with 10. Indy 500 winner Lee Wallard is third with 9 points, fourth place Ascari has 6, and Taruffi is in fifth with also 6 points. Dear Grand Prix TV enthusiasts, thank you for joining us on this thrilling journey through the 1951 Formula One season. Your passion fuels our excitement for each race. But the adventure isn't over. Buckle up for the upcoming spectacle, the 1951 French Grand Prix. Get ready for heart-pounding action, fierce competition, and the roar of engines at the iconic Circuit de Ramsgueux. Hit that subscribe button and stay tuned for the next chapter in this historic racing saga. The French Grand Prix promises to be a race for the ages,